mistook the bleach for mouthwash. Her parents sat around her bed throughout her hospital stay, as if guarding her to make sure she wouldn't say what really happened, and to make sure she went home with them. However, a fellow patient did manage to ask Shvelia why she drank the bleach. Shvelia replied, "You don't know what they did to me," and explained that it was the only way for her to get out of there. In September 2003, after being discharged from hospital and taken back home by her parents, things seemed to have settled down, but no. Shvelia tried to restart her life and got a call center job and started going to college. Surprise, surprise, her parents didn't like that. Shvelia had been back in touch with her old friends, who then tried to visit her at home, but were all told to go away. She wasn't allowed any contact with them, and her phone was taken away. So the abuse started again, once it was clear she was still not going to conform to their rules. On September 11th, Shvelia was picked up from work by her mother, Fazana. 7 days later, on September 18th, she was reported missing, this time not by her parents, but her former teacher, Joanne Code. Joanne had overheard rumors that went around school, saying that something had happened to Shvelia.